For this demo, I'm going to put myself in the shoes of a project manager. And you can see here that I've got several projects that I've segmented into a non-technical folder and a technical folder. I have three technical projects and all need to be connected to Jira, because for this Android app project, the iOS app project, and the website revamp, I need help from the developers. So I'm going to need to connect Wrike and Jira via Wrike Project Sync. Now, let me switch to the flows that I've actually built via Wrike Project Sync. Here they are. There's three of them, one for each Wrike project. And all three are syncing with just one Jira project called apps and website. All three flows have pretty much the same settings. So I've used the duplicate feature right here. I'll go into one of the flows, show you how it is set up, and then we'll show you the magic in action. So whether you connect Wrike and Jira or other tools, the four same steps would apply. The first step would be about connecting your tools and your projects. So here we're choosing Wrike and Jira, super straightforward, and more specifically, my Android app project in Wrike and the apps and website project in Jira. That's all there is to this first step. The second step would be about your flow direction. So here, we're not asking you whether you want comments to go both ways or dates to go both ways. We're asking where your items get created. So in my case, I want to create tasks in Wrike to send to my developers in Jira, but I also want to allow my developers to have the flexibility to create issues from scratch in Jira to send to me in Wrike. Therefore, I'm choosing the two arrows here. Now that we've decided what the flow direction should be, we're going to decide which items have to sync from one tool to another. Some of our customers decide to mirror, we could say, everything from Wrike to Jira or Jira to Wrike. In this situation, what we'll do is narrow it down so it's only a subset of tasks that actually sync from one tool to another. More specifically, what I've done is from Wrike to Jira, I'm saying that my open tasks in the Android app project that have the field called collaboration set to devs should go to Jira. I'll show you this field later on in Wrike. Basically, it's a multi-select. And what it means is if I select dev, I need help from the developers, right? So this is a trigger for Unito to send Wrike task to Jira. And then the other way, if a developer creates an issue in Jira, they'll simply need to label the issue with Android app for Unito to understand that it needs to create a Wrike task. So now that we've decided the flow direction, which items are syncing, the last step of the process is about which pieces of information on these items are meant to sync. So that's your fields mappings. Some were mapped automatically when I created the flow, which saved me time. Others I've mapped myself. And you can see that, for example, the comments are going both ways, because obviously for collaboration purposes, it's better for comments to go both ways. But other fields like sprint, time spent, and epic, I've only mapped one way. This is up to the devs to decide what epic it's related to, how long they spend on a task, and which sprint it's part of. Should the Wrike team modify this in Wrike? By mistake, it would not impact the Jira side. And you can notice that there are gear icons next to some of the fields. It means you can expand these fields and customize the mapping. So I'll show you an example that is interesting here for status mapping. You notice that on the left side, which is Wrike, I have more statuses than I do on the Jira side. But that's okay, because what I can do here is say both the statuses to do and active equate to just to do on the Jira side. So I'm sort of grouping my statuses and customizing the mapping so that it makes sense for my workflow. So you don't have to have exactly the same fields and names on in Jira and Wrike. You can adjust that afterwards in Unito. You can append the Jira issue number to your Wrike task titles. Sometimes, you know, when referring to an issue, you might talk to a dev and refer to AW15 rather than talking about the name of the task. So that's an option. You don't have to toggle this, but I'll leave it on just to show you in the demo. So that's all there is to setting up a flow. And I'm going to go back to Wrike. This is my Android app project. So I'm going to create an item. I'm going to call this the app keeps crashing. So I'm going to decide that this is a bug. I'm going to add a description here. I'm going to comment away And I'm going to leave the sprint and the milestone empty. That's for the devs to fill out. I'm going to switch the collaboration field to devs. Otherwise, this task would never actually land in Jira. What I'll do to get a little bit more fancy is I'll ask for a due date and I'll add two sub items. And what I want to show you with these sub items is the first one I'll leave as is, but the second one I will change to collaboration is dev to show you that if you have lots of sub items, provided some are meeting the criteria, they will sync to Jira, but those who don't will stay in Wrike. So now we just wait for the magic to happen. You can see that you need to synchronize the task. And the reason I do know this is because in the description, I now have a line that says task is synchronized with this Jira bug by Unito, which is nice because I can click on the word bug and that leads me straight to the Jira issue. You can see that the description came across. I've got a label that automatically tells me where that's coming from in Wrike, which is nice to have. And the sub item number two, which is the one that met the criteria, came across while the first one didn't come across, which is exactly what I wanted. So I'm going to change a few things here. I'm going to say that this is now in progress. I'm going to comment back on the task because the devs might want to indicate they started working on this. I'm going to add this to a sprint and maybe I'll add an epic as well. So now that I've done all this, I'll go back to Wrike, probably refresh the page. And what I want to show you as well is that here, see how the Jira issue number came across. So now if I want to talk to the devs, I can refer to it as the app keeps crashing bug, or I can say AW18, depending on what we prefer. So my comments from Jira came across. You can see that now the milestone in Wrike indicates epic Y. It's part of a sprint and the due date has changed because the sprint I've indicated in Jira is starting in July. So my due date that I had initially set in Wrike changed because the devs are saying, well, we'll tackle this in July. The status was changed as well from to do to in progress. If I go to my backlog and create a brand new task, I'm going to call this with something a bit more original. Maybe your hair looks good, Mark, for a change. What I'll do is I'll select a label called iOS app because that's an issue created by a dev from Jira, from scratch. And by applying this label iOS app, what I'm expecting is for this Jira issue to go straight into Wrike in the iOS folder. So let me go there now. It hasn't landed yet, but now we wait. And here it is. And it's AW20, your hair looks good, Mark. Let's see, it's a task. The task type was set to task, which is perfect. And automatically the collaboration field was set to devs, which is nice. So this completes the demo, but now at least you know how with just a few Unito flows, you can help business teams collaborate with your development or IT teams.